¡Vámonos!
The singer is American superstar Jim Morrison, leader of a Californian rock and roll band called The Doors.
Name? Robbie Krieger. Age? 22 years old.
Occupation?
Guitar. Name?
John Densmore.
Age?
23.
Occupation?
Percussionist.
Name?
Raymond Daniel Manzuri.
Age?
Born 2/12/39.
Occupation?
Musician.
Organist.
Name?
Jim. Occupation?
Through his music, Morrison comments on society as he sees it. He speaks for a generation who has filched their descent onto the streets of the world. To them, he is poet, prophet, and politician.
I think these days, especially in the States, you have to be a politician or an assassin or something to really be a superstar.
'65, '66, '67, '68, '69, 1970, there was a group called The Doors, and The Doors tried to get out as far as they could, man, and to take the audience with them.
Especially Jim, you know, he would be on the edge of reality all the time, and that's what came through the music, I think, and that's what I think is happening today.
Jim Morrison is someone that I maybe knew as well as anybody, but then there was still so much about him I couldn't find out.
I can't say too much about it because we're not really making it. It's just kind of making itself.
Come on. Woo! Yeah!
first heard them, I wasn't grabbed at all by the Doors. I saw them a first set at the Whiskey, and it was a pretty bad set. I figured, well, here's a good opportunity to make sure that the Doors get a second listen. In those days, groups didn't frequently get a second listening from the record company, and I stayed for a second set, and they were great. The second set, they were incredible.
On one hand, you had little 10-year-old teeny boppers reading about Jim Morrison in 16 magazine with his shirt off. Then on the other hand, you had magazines like Cheetah and Crawdaddy and writers like Paul Williams and Richard Goldstein and The Village Voice writing about them on totally intellectual levels. You know, on one hand, there was totally this teeny bopper level and then an intellectual level. They appealed to so many people on so many different levels. So, yeah, they were top 10, but they were also, as much as they were pop and bubblegum, they were also Dread and intelligence and theater and drama.
Jim's contribution to music was that Jim was real. Jim was real on stage. Jim was real when he wrote his songs, when he sang his songs in the studio. He was not a performer. He was not an entertainer. He was not a showman. He was a shaman. He was possessed, man. The guy was possessed by a vision, by a madness, by a rage to live, by an all-consuming fire to make art, man.
I think what Morrison was doing and what we were trying to do in those days was reality on stage and, you know, and the music. It was more like what we were really feeling rather than like a show or a sort of an act, you know. We were really doing what we really felt on stage.
Our songs were set up so there'd be like a verse and chorus, and then there'd be sections of improvising instrumentally or lyrically. And that's where he was free to throw anything in or do whatever he wanted. And that's what was exciting. Scary, but exciting.
The mood I get for most of it is kind of a heavy, kind of a sort of gloomy feeling, you know? Like of someone not quite at home, or, you know, or not quite relaxed and, you know, aware of a lot of things, but not quite sure about anything. You know, I'd like to do one just feeling of being totally at home.
Wake up!
Snake was pale gold, glazed and shrunken. We were afraid to touch it. The sheets were hot, dead prison. And she was beside me. Red hair, the white soft skin.